Hello, Realvolve community. My name is Mark Stepp. I am the Chief Innovation Officer here at Realvolve, and I am happy to announce that phase two of our contact cross-section is complete and ready to use. We've added a new layer to the contact cross-section so that it has two views, a filtered view where the filter is on, and an unfiltered view which the filter is off. This was our original view. To change the view, simply click on the word filter in the upper right-hand corner to toggle between on or off. The new filter shows the number of contacts grouped by status and stage, which needs to be contacted because their last call date or last personal visit is over a threshold value. So what does that really mean? So now you can set up a maximum number of days between a personal call or visit. You can go under Settings, Set Default Fields, and then Dashboard to see the contact follow-up settings. These are our threshold settings. The threshold values can be different for each contact status and ABCD categories. You can use the value of 0 if you don't want to be notified for a specific group. When the number of days since the last call or personal visit goes over that threshold value for a given contact, Realvolve will include that contact in the heat map along with the total count for that group. You should concentrate your efforts on the squares that are darker red. The darker the red in a given cross-section square, the more contacts there are in that section. Click on a square to see the list of contacts. The names at the top of the list have the greater number of days over the threshold setting. These are the people that you should call or visit first. Click on a name to see the details of that particular contact. You can view the full contact by clicking on the name at the top, or you can create notes, emails, SMS text messages, or update the date values of the fields for the last call date, last email date, last personal visit, or last personal note, as well as updating a postponed contact date. This is useful for contacts that have requested you call them after a given date. The most recent date of the two fields, last call date or last personal visit, is the most recent meaningful touch point known as the last action date. If you call or visit and update the appropriate date field, the contact will be removed from the list until the next threshold is crossed again. So how is this really useful? Let's assume that you want to personally communicate with your past clients every 120 days. By simply entering the last call date or last personal visit, Realvolve will notify you when the past client has hit that threshold value of 120 days. The cross-section shows how many contacts are over the threshold value and gives you a list of those contacts you should call. Some days you might be able to call 5 past clients, and other days you can call more. The contact cross-section keeps your contacts in the list until you've changed that last call date or last personal visit date, or assigned that postponed date. With our flexible configuration, you can assign different threshold values for suspect, prospect, lead, clients, past clients, as well as those contacts that are in the A, B, C, D categories. Typically, your A and B contacts are more important and more frequent communication is desired. Prior to this enhancement, Realvolve required you to set up a workflow to notify you when to call the contact every 90 days or so. With this filtered contact cross-section, you no longer need that workflow on each contact. Simply assign your threshold values, and Realvolve will display the contacts as they come due. It is important that you assign that initial last call date or last personal visit date in order for the contacts to show in the filtered list. If the contact does not have either of the values in those date fields, it will not show in the filtered list. With this enhancement, you should be able to quickly see those contacts that you need to call or visit with very little effort. If you have additional questions, please visit our help site or reach out to our support team. We'll be happy to help. Have a great day.